Okay, this is just a little demo of the Digital Effects skin, showing some of its capabilities and plugins and features in it. As you can see right now, we've got kind of a burlwood looking theme going on with an orange clock in the center here. That can be changed at any time by going into the skin settings here. And you basically click change skin color, and you pick whatever you want. Blue S is kind of nice looking. So let's change the skin color to that. And we'll go back. And you can pick a different 3D logo. Let's see. There's a lot of different types of clocks you can choose, as well as different 3D spinning logos. I'll change it to a Mitsubishi as I drive the clips. And now when we go back to the main menu, you can see the whole skin is changing color, as well as the logo in the center there. Alright, let's go to the music screen now. There's a few things in here. One of my favorites is the new library search. If you've got a particular song in mind, you can't think of the entire name. Like, there was a song by Meatloaf that had something with the word light or something in it. So let's just try a couple of keywords here. Meat and light. And see what we come up with. There we are, Meatloaf, Paradise by the Dashboard Lights. Now you can either double click that song to play instantly, but in this case I'm going to click the play album and it will load every single song from that album into the playlist. And of course you can jump through them and such. There's a title search, you can click most played. The library actually keeps track of what songs you play the most, which is kind of cool. It's kind of almost a favorites. Back to the main menu again. And if we go into weather, there's a couple of key things in here. As you can see, the five buttons at the top here, GPS weather, will show you the weather for your current location. The other five other four are programmable. Say we've got Phoenix here. If I press and hold it, the on-screen keyboard will pop up. And I'll type in Seattle. And now we've got the Seattle, Washington weather. And you can click these buttons to get different weather for different places that you might be interested in. As far as the radar, it's animated, loops, satellite, same thing. Interactive weather I just added recently, and that's using the Weather Channel information that's overlaid over Microsoft Live Maps. So you can kind of zoom into your area, drag the map around, and you can control the transparency if you want to see through it to see where your neighborhood is and who's getting rain and not. And clicking here, you can also animate it. Unfortunately, the buttons are kind of tiny for a touch screen, but I haven't found a way around that yet. But it was too neat not to include in the skin. Let's go back to the main menu again. And we've got, if you click anywhere on the song name at the top here, you can bring up the star rating. This song has not been rated yet. So let's make it a 3-star. And now that'll actually add it to a 3-star playlist, as well as the other songs that were in there, and it displays on here as well. Actually, that's the current song. Alright, if we go into the GPS screen, there's a couple of things in here that's kind of cool. Gas being one of them. Unfortunately, the screen recording software, there's a little bit of a flicker when I actually try to do this, but we'll give it a try. 7-Eleven, we'll go ahead and click Map It, because that's a pretty good gas price, close to us. And all you should see is this screen here, but with a screen recorder going, for some reason eye guidance is coming from the front.
For GPS signal.
That doesn't happen in the car. And of course it maps your route to the gas station. And while we're in here, let's go ahead and pause the music for a second. A lot of people have wondered what the new eye guidance 4.0 sounds like with a text-to-speech. So I'm going to hit a keyboard shortcut here, actually. And we'll give it a try.
In 2.3 miles, turn left onto Hippolyxo Road.
As you can hear, the voice is actually quite a bit better than the old canned wave files. So, it's kind of handy. I'll go ahead and cancel this route. Auto configuration. I let you turn the auto switching on and off. If you're on the main menu and you've got a turn approaching, you can actually have eye guidance pop to the front to show you the turn, and then it'll return to the screen you were before. You can have it pause the music when it's speaking. A couple of different things in here you can set up. There's a couple of layouts as well for the GPS screen. As you can see, the music on the top right now. And we've got like a widescreen view of the map with buttons across the top and bottom. And then there's one with just the tall screen with nothing. So let's go back here to this one, the wide layout. And you'll notice when we leave and come back, it remembers a layout of the screen that you used. Even after Roadrunner's restarted, it'll always remember the last layout that you used. Alright, so back to the main menu, and let's start the music back up. If you click anywhere on the time or the top of this box, you can actually start a visualization that goes into the background of the main menu. Clicking the date at the bottom, you can change the color and style of the visualization. Visualization is being used. There we go. Blue goes with the blue pretty well. So let's turn that back off. Go back into the music, and we can turn the visualize on in here as well. And get an idea. Clicking on the left goes back a visualization, and on the right goes forward, so you can kind of jump through it. Browser screen, there's one handy feature. On the album art over here, if you touch your touch screen and spin on the circle, if you go slow, you'll see the list is actually scrolling slow. If you move your finger around quick, you can see the list kind of buzzes through. It's kind of a quick way to get around through your music collection. And if you find something you scroll to and you want to actually listen to it, click the center and it'll open that artist up on the screen for you. Alright, back to the main menu again. If we go into video, that actually kind of works the same way. You can't see the video I am right now because I'm using a screen recorder. But if you go through the movies here, clicking anywhere on the album cover over here will also scroll through your DVDs or movies or videos that you have ripped through the hard drive, which is kind of cool. Alright, back to the main menu one more time. And going into the utilities screen, there's a few different things. Calculator, scroll pad, pretty standard for most of the skins out there. Media copy is kind of handy because you can actually go through, and if you plug a thumb drive in, the drives that you see on the left right here are actually the hard drives on the computer. When you go to the skin, it actually scans and shows you your drive letters. So you can browse through any drive letters, and if you find a plug a thumb drive in, you just say it's on drive E, you click E, you see your music, you can click on it, and then just say copy to music, and it will copy it to Roadrunner's default music folder. So it's then in your library in the car. Makes it quick to add videos or music and such to the computer just through the skin and touch screen. Vehicle maintenance, kind of handy as well. I think Chuck wrote this originally, and I just updated a little bit. You type in the date, you know, what you had done, the last mileage, and your interval, and after you type in the interval, it will automatically update this last column here to show you when your next scheduled change is. Kind of handy just to remember little things on the car to do. Gas prices, we saw that through the GPS screen a minute ago, traffic cams, camera, calendar. This is done with, I can't remember the calendar name now, Rainlander. So you can, just a quick little calendar in the car that you can use to check dates or whatever. Alright, back to the main menu. One of the handy things in the music screen, the main player, is a lot of people like to stay on the screen, but you also want to see what's going on with the GPS. Anytime you see this little icon on the skin means that the GPS will embed somewhere on that screen. So that's kind of handy. You know, you can have all your music controls over here and also your GPS. And what's kind of handy is, I don't know if it's a bug or not, but you can actually put the visualization over the top of iGuidance, which looks kind of cool. It's different. Back to the main menu. And a lot of these features I can't show you because the hardware for my radio and for the satellite radio and the phone, everything's all out in the car, so I don't have that set up inside here to do anything with. Under the settings screen, you've got GPS volume control, basic. You set a speed for your car. As you know, when you increase speed, it gets a little noisier and it's harder to hear the radio. You can have this adjust the volume automatically when you're driving down the road and increasing speed. Skins and gamma, pretty basic. You know, you browse through your different skins here. And day skin, night skin, gamma, I mean, it's all pretty self-explanatory. Got a lot of control panel access too, like for your wireless network and Bluetooth settings and display settings on your car computer. Makes it a little easier than trying to do it through the control panel on a touchscreen interface. That's basically just about it. It's a quick rundown of the Digital Effects skin and some of its features. Thanks for watching.